A few weeks ago, I received an email from Dr. William Duffy, who suggested that AI would be a good topic for this video series. And Dr. Duffy, you're right. I agreed with the email. Thank you for taking the time to send me the email. Now, you're an associate professor and the director of graduate studies in the Department of English.
That's right.
So I'm sure some people think, AI, English? How does that go together? So tell us about AI in teaching and what you and your colleagues are doing there.
One of the most important things we're doing right now is giving students the chance to experiment and tinker with some of these tools in a way that can help them understand how the learning process works itself. I want students to not only get acquainted with how this technology is actually going to impact the work that they're going to be doing once they leave college, but also because there are so many questions and concerns surrounding it. Many students are unsure if there's value to be had. Many more are nervous and apprehensive about using these tools in such formal learning environments. And one of the things that I want to do is help students feel empowered to experiment and tinker with these tools in a way that actually improves the skills and the dispositions that they bring into the workplace.
I remember something, and I think it's some research that you're doing that you passed along, that faculty seem to be very open-minded about the use of AI,
yeah.
And students are actually more apprehensive than the faculty. And I think most people would suggest that or think that would be the other way around, right? That the faculty may be more closed-minded and the students would be, you know, really embracing, but it's the other way around, right?
That's right, that's right. With my department colleague, Elliot Cazal, we're doing some institutional research when we just want to understand what do University of Memphis stakeholders think about these, about this technology.
Yeah.
And so far we found through survey work, we found that the majority of undergraduates are the most apprehensive about these tools in the classroom. And in part that might be because so many of us, again, aren't quite sure how to address appropriate use. But yes, students are most apprehensive, and graduate students are the ones who are most eager to experiment with these tools.
My wife is going to hate me for mentioning this during this video, but I used AI, I used ChatGPT to write a Valentine's poem for my wife, and she loved it. And then I had to confess that I didn't actually write it myself,
right.
That it was ChatGPT.
Right.
You know, so does that count?
Absolutely. Well, listen, yeah. So this is what I tell students, right, is that the trick is not to figure out how to get these tools to do our work for us.
Right.
That's not the goal. The goal is to figure out how these tools can help us do our work better, more efficiently, more effectively. And the important thing that a lot of people realize is that human beings are really important. And that poem to your wife still meant something because you at least had to sign off and prompt it.
Yeah.
So there's some bill in that poem for sure.
Well, at least I'm telling myself that.
That's
anyway.
Right.
Hey, where can people find out more information about the work you're doing?
Our website, the English Department website.
All right, fantastic. Dr. Duffy, thanks for being with us today. I appreciate
Absolutely.
It.
Absolutely.